Hey guys, today's tutorial is going to be on this cute little bird's nest, and I think this is a really good painting to do for beginners. It's pretty simple shapes and lines. So let's get started. The paints I'm going to use are melted chocolate, sable brown, burlap, antique white, regular white. I've got an English ivy green, a true green, and Atlantis. And you'll need a little bit of black too. All right, so let's start out. I think this is dry. I just painted it white. All right, we're gonna sketch in our egg and our nest. So we're just gonna do three egg shapes. I do them where they're kind of all like sitting on top of each other. You can do them all separate if you want, or you know, however you want to arrange your eggs. But I want mine like kind of sitting on each other. To do the nest, we're just gonna draw just kind of a circle around your eggs. And then on the bottom of the nest, you're going to go down, drag it down just a little bit. That's where we're gonna have kind of some shadowing to show the depth of the nest. So we'll kind of do that just around to the edge there. And we need something that the nest is sitting on. So we're going to draw in some branches. Kind of wherever you want. You can do them as thick as you want or as thin. I'm going to draw in another one here. Okay. It's a little longer than what I wanted. Okay. That's the basic idea. All right, so for the background, I'm gonna get my mop brush, and I'm gonna get it wet, and I'm gonna take the Atlantis color, and you want your brush to be pretty wet, so I'm just gonna dab off some of the water, and I'm gonna take a chunk of the Atlantis, put it over here. I'm gonna get, little bit of my white and add it. I want a pale blue, so I'll probably need to use a bunch of white to pale that out enough. This is going to be our background. So because your robin's eggs are going to be a bright blue, you want this to be, we're going to use the same blue for the robin's egg, so you really want this to be pretty light. Let me grab some more white here. You can also use just a different light blue if you want, but these are the, I just used the one blue. Okay, so now that we have it mixed, I'm washing off my brush. And again, you want it pretty watery, so I'm just blotting. And I'm gonna take some of that paint that we just mixed and just kind of wash it around in there. And the water from your brush should make this kind of opaque, almost like a watercolor effect. If it's not, then you need a little more water. If you got too much water, you'll be able to tell because your paint will end up looking kind of streaky. So you can just adjust as you need, not a big deal. Okay, and we're just gonna start filling in our background here. Right. All right, now you're gonna want that to dry before we start putting in our leaves. For our leaves, we're gonna use, we're gonna do the shadow part of the leaves first, so the darker parts of the leaves. So we're gonna use that English ivy dark green. This isn't quite dry yet. I'm gonna stop the video and give this a minute to dry, and then we'll come back. All right, that blue is pretty dry. So now I'm gonna go in with that mop brush, and I'm gonna grab that dark green, and we're gonna do the same thing. So you want it watered down. So just pull a little off to the side and just kind of mop your brush in it. You just want it kind of loaded. And we're gonna almost sloppily kind of put in just some background, right? So you're just gonna, you just want to assume that there are leaves here, right? So we're not making out a certain actual leaf shape. We're just giving people something to look at so that they can, they're going to assume that there are leaves, that the nest is in the leaves. All right, so you're gonna take that same dark green and you're gonna lightly go under the nest. And then in that same area, you're gonna grab just a tiny bit of black and mix it in with your green on your brush. And go in there, need a little bit more to give that, because that's gonna be shadowed under there. Go on in now with your dark brown. It's the melted chocolate. And we're gonna go on and put in our branches. So wherever you had mapped out for your branches to go, you want to put them in. We're gonna put more leaves over top of that, so don't worry about it looking weird. Let's see. Like antlers. So I'm gonna take that out because that would drive me bananas. When your paint is still wet, all I did was I just wetted my brush, and then you can just drag along, because if the paint isn't dry yet, the water will just take it right off. Okay, you can see the dark green, there's still wet spots. You want it pretty much dry. It doesn't have to be totally dry, but you want it pretty dry. So we'll go on in. I'm gonna grab a different brush. I'm gonna grab, look, it's all peel. It's a round. I think it's like a medium or a small round or something. All right, so I'm gonna go on and we're gonna go, fill in the shadowing around the egg. So I'm gonna grab a little bit of black. Let me see if I can bring this over here. All right, so I'm gonna grab just a little bit of black off to the side here, and then I'm gonna mix it with a little bit of brown. I want a darker brown that isn't quite black. All right, and then I'm just gonna go around the, like where the eggs would sit. So, you know, the light's not going to shine directly under the egg. So that's the shadow that you're creating. You want that dark. All right, and then from there, you're going to take, you're going to wash your brush off, and then just take your melted chocolate brown and go out from there. And you're just gonna take it out to the boundary that you set for your nest. And I'm gonna take it down into my shadow just a tad. That'll all be covered up with the twigs that we're gonna put in. All right, I'm washing off my brush, and then I'm gonna get my lighter brown. I think this was the sable brown. And I'm gonna go right on top of the brown I just put in, just for some variant of color. Wash your brush off. And then I'm gonna go in with my light brown. I think it's a burlap color. And I'm gonna go along the edge of the nest. We're not putting in the actual twig shapes yet. So this is just laying in whatever color we want for the background of our nest. All right, I think my dark green is dry enough. So I'm gonna go in again with my mop brush. I'm gonna get it wet. You don't want it quite as wet as the as when you did the dark green, but kind of somewhat wet. And I'm gonna get the true green color. Rub my brush in it. And then I'm gonna go on top of these leaves. Just kind of throw in wherever. Again, they don't need to be the exact shape of a leaf because the concentration is going to be on the nest. And everyone, your eye's not gonna be drawn to the individual leaves or what color they're making or what shape they're making or not making. They're just going to assume that there is leaves there. So don't worry about it, just throw some in there. I'm gonna do some going down the thing here. All right, once you're done with that layer of leaves, I'm gonna wipe my brush off again, set that aside. Now we're gonna go in and do robin's eggs. So grab the Atlantis color, and then we're just gonna fill in the egg shape there. Don't worry about the eggs running together. We will add in the separating shadow line when we're done shading our eggs. Okay. All right, so we filled in that color. Now I'm gonna grab a little bit of white. And I'm gonna go in on the tops and add in some of the white. And I'm just gonna blend that into the blue that I just put in. The tops of the eggs are gonna be lighter than the bottom because that's where the sunlight is hitting them. So, you know, just if you can imagine that in your head, you wanna do the tops that are gonna be a lot whiter than the bottom parts of your eggs. Hey, honey bear. My dog came in. Hey, big girl. Okay. You can see the egg starting to take shape, kind of a three-dimensional shape. once we got that set in there, I've just got some, you know, the white highlights and then the darker blue. I'm going to add in a little more of the Atlantis just along where the eggs touch, just to create that darker shadow. I'm going to go in with a little bit of your dark brown. And you're going to go along the edges of the eggs where they meet together. You want to keep it as thin as possible. And then just kind of blend it out where it's too big of a line. And it'll create that shadow. Uh-oh, that's not good. Took out the white where I needed it to be. So I'm going to add that back in there. I'm going to go on top of that brown, add a little bit of blue in. There you go. So you're just changing the color of the shadows in between the eggs. So it's kind of like a brown blue. Okay. Grab a little bit of white here and reshape that egg. It's looking a little non-egg like. Okay. All right, now let's get that down a little bit more. Now we're gonna go in and do our twigs. So I'm going to switch brushes to this fine line brush. Can you see that? All right, so I'm gonna get it wet, and then I'm gonna wipe it on my towel so that it makes like a point. And I'm just gonna use the different color browns. So we've got the melted chocolate, the real brown, or whatever that one was called, sable brown, and burlap, and I'm going to use these just kind of interchangeably. I'm going to start with the melted chocolate, so I'm getting it on my brush, and we're just going to start making thin lines around the nest. The medium brown, so the sable brown, and you're just continuing with those lines. And you want the circular shape of the nest. I'm going to go in with my burlap now. And again, you're doing the same thing over and over, just creating those little twigs that are going everywhere in the nest. But you still want to maintain that circular pattern. But some of the twigs, you know, will be going out and will be, you know, not perfect in the nest. Go back in with my melted chocolate color, and this is just gonna take some time. You know, you're just building up those twigs. You want to give as much of a visual as you can of a real nest, you know, and if you look at a real nest, they're, I don't know, hundreds, thousands of things that it takes for little birds to put it together, so you're wanting to mimic that in some way. I'm gonna go on in. I'm losing some of the depth of my nest, so I'm gonna go back in with my melted brown mixed with a little black. I'm gonna kind of mix back in my shadow. Sorry, I got my brush too wet. All right, so I'm gonna go in here, just gently add back in the bottom and the sides here of the nest. My different browns, and now I'm gonna try to go around that shadow and not in it, so that we don't give the inside of our nest, we don't want it to disappear. Where this egg is, I'm going to add a little bit more shadowing on the actual egg itself. Uh-oh. My brush was too wet. So I'm going to get a little bit of the Atlantis blue mixed with a little brown. Alright, now I'm going to take some of the browns that I have and mix in just a little white, because I just want different, some other shades of brown in there. So I'm going to take that dark brown and just start mixing some of my browns together to get different tones. I'll throw those in there. Just added in some shadow there with black and brown under the nest. Now I'm going to go in with black and just going to throw in just some random spots with some black. Now I'm going to take the antique white and throw that in there. That's going to kind of be your highlighting twigs. Alright, I'm going to go in one more time with my melted chocolate and throw in some final twigs in there with that color. gotten this done. So now we are going to go in with the medium round brush. And I'm going to take the, where is it? There it is. My two greens. Let's see. We'll do the, I'm going to do the dark green, this ivy. I'll pull it to the side, add a little white to it. And I'm going to wipe my brush off. I want it a little wet. You want that same mop type effect. All right, and then we're going to go in and throw some final leaves in here. And these, some of them can kind of, you know, touch the nest if you want. Then on top of that, I'm going to go in with my antique white, same thing, water it down a little bit, and just barely tap into kind of the wet leaves that you just did. Alright, and then the finishing thing, I'm going to take that dark green, ivy green. I'm going to add a touch of black to it. Pack it on my brush. And I'm just going to bring in the shadow of the nest a little behind it. And I'm just kind of dotting it in. Adding a little more under here. Just letting that shadow kind of fade into the greenery underneath. And I took this a little too out a little too far, so I'm just gonna add back in some leaves. All right, there you have it. Little robin's egg.